Hello friends, this is a video lecture on female external genitalia. External means the part that is seen from outside. Actually, the female reproductive system consists of internal as well as external. Internal parts are not given here, only we will discuss about the external parts. The internal parts include uterus, vagina, cervix, etc. But here we don't discuss about them. We will discuss only about external genitalia. So here we start. As you see the structure over here, this is the structure. External genitalia means vulva. This part. We'll come closer to the photo. Now this part is a fatty sheath. This is called Mons pubis. This is clitoris. This is glands of clitoris. This part is labia majora or labium majus. This one is labia minora. Minora is inside. This is vaginal opening. This is covered by a membranous sheath called hymen. Hymen is actually the sign of virginity. Nowadays, it does not mean virginity because most of the time, the hymen breaks off during athletics or any kind of severe exercises. But previously the women did not used to come out of their homes, so this was the sign of their virginity. Now this part is known as foreshed. This is anus and this is perineum. Perineum is up to the anus. This part is the perineum. Now we'll discuss about it. Vulva is the global term that describes the external female genitalia. Its components are mons pubis, labium majus or labia majora, labium minus, labia minora, clitoris, vestibular bulbs, Bartholin's glands, Skene's glands and vaginal orifice. The mons pubis is a tissue mound of fat anterior to the pubic bones. It is covered with pubic hairs. Its functions are, it acts as source of cushioning during coitus. Its sebaceous glands secrete pheromones to induce sexual attraction. Labium majus is the larger lip-like structure. Cutaneous skin folds that covers labia minora, or clitoris, vagina and the glands. This covers the entire thing. It engorges with blood and appears edematous during sexual arousal. Labium minus or labia minora are the smaller lips. These are small cutaneous folds beginning at the clitoris extending downwards. Anterior folds encircle the clitoris to form clitoral hood and frenulum of clitoris. It also appears edematous during sexual arousal. Clitoris are the erectile structures homologous to male penis formed by two corpora cavernosa and the glands covered by prepuce. It is connected to mons pubis and pubic symphysis by a suspensory ligament and richly equipped with sensory nerves. During sexual arousal, it becomes engorged. This is highly erectile structure, means highly it gets erect during sexual arousal. Bartholin's glands are present over here. These are located slightly posterior to the left and right of vaginal opening. These secrete mucus to lubricate the vagina and are homologous to bulbourethral glands in males. The glands of Skene, these are located around the urethral opening, also known as paraurethral glands. These are involved in sexual stimulation and lubrication for sexual intercourse. These are homologue to prostate gland of males. These also produce antimicrobial secretion. Fourchette. These are two folds of skin of labia minora are joined together by a small fold of skin called fourchette or little fork. It gets torn during childbirth or violent sexual act. So with this, we end our external genitalia. So now, please subscribe and share the video to as many people as possible so that they can also have the same viewing as you are doing it. Please do it. Thank you.